If there is anyone out there who still doubts that America is a place where all things are possible, who still wonders if the dream of our founders is alive in our time, who still questions the power of our democracy, tonight is your answer.
I voted for Barack because Barack is the rock, and we need a change, and it's time for a change. Time to get rid of the old stuff and bring in the new.
Hi, I voted for Barack Obama this morning. I always knew he was the best man for the job. I always vote based on who's the best person to run the country. And from day one that he announced his presidency or his run for candidacy, I knew he was the best man for the job.
It's the answer told by lines that stretched around schools and churches in numbers this nation has never seen. By people who waited 3 hours, 4 hours, many for the first time in their lives, because they believed that this time must be different, that their voices could be that difference.
Hi, we voted for Barack Obama for a change for America, to bring people together and to hope for a better future. Thank you, Barack Obama, the next president for America. Thank you.
Hi, my name's Raj. I supported Barack Obama because he never would have got us into this war.
It's the answer spoken by young and old, rich and poor, Democrat and Republican, black, white, Hispanic, Asian, Native American, gay, straight, disabled and not disabled, Americans who sent a message to the world that we have never been just a collection of individuals or a collection of red states and blue states. We are and always will be the United States of America.
I'm supporting Barack Obama because I feel that he represents what I stand for. For the first time in a presidential race, I'm excited.
Why did I vote for Obama? One, I believe that he just has the vigor, you know, something that we've been missing for a long time. Young people, African Americans, you know, young white youth or whatever. We've just been waiting for someone with a lot of energy and just the passion that he has for a lot of the issues. So that's why I vote Obama.
It's been a long time coming. But tonight, because of what we did on this day, in this election, at this defining moment, change has come to America.
In Indiana because I believe he is the best candidate. He can bring America back to his glory, and I really think that he'll be a great addition to young people and getting us so involved in our political future. So congratulations, Barack Obama, for even making this far.
Hi, I'm Whitney, and I supported Barack Obama because I think that he would be the best leader, and that's what this country needs. We need to come together and follow a good leader, and we need to have someone who will put
above all, I will never forget who this victory truly belongs to. It belongs to you. It belongs to you. I was never the likeliest candidate for this office. We didn't start with much money or many endorsements. Our campaign was not hatched in the halls of Washington. It began in the backyards of Des Moines, the living rooms of Concord, and the front porches of Charleston. It was built by working men and women who dug into what little savings they had to give $5 and $10 and $20 to the cause. It grew strength from the young people who rejected the myth of their generation's apathy, who left their homes and their families for jobs that offered little pay and less sleep. It drew strength from the not so young people who braved the bitter cold and scorching heat to knock on doors of perfect strangers, and from the millions of Americans who volunteered and organized and proved that more than two centuries later, a government of the people, by the people, and for the people has not perished from the earth. This is your victory.
I support Barack Obama because he's awesome. You're awesome if you're watching this. We never would have gone into the war without, you know, if you were elected 4 years ago or 8 years ago, and you gave me hope, and that's it.
I'm
president that I am excited about and that other people are excited about. Ready for a change and a new start.
I promise you, we as a people will get there.
I am Pastor Derek Jones of the Sunshine Missionary Baptist Church. I teach at Percy L. Junior High School, and I am here supporting Barack Obama because I wanted a change for my children and for America, and I believe in what he's doing. I believe there's going to be a better country as a result of him.
And all those watching tonight from beyond our shores, from parliaments and palaces, to those who are huddled around radios in the forgotten corners of the world, our stories are singular, but our destiny is shared. And a new dawn of American leadership is at hand. To those who would tear the world down, we will defeat you. To those who seek peace and security, we support you.
I support Barack Obama because I believe this country needs a change. We need a fresh way of looking at things, a new mindset. We need to start thinking outside the box. We need to start making some changes in order to bring America back to where we were in the past.
Hi, I'm Marissa, and I support Barack Obama. It's time for a fresh breath of air, a change here.
This election had many firsts, many stories that will be told for generations, but one that's on my mind tonight is about a woman who cast her ballot in Atlanta.
Yes, we did!
She's a lot like the millions of others who stood in line to make their voice heard in this election, except for one thing. Ann Nixon Cooper is 106 years old.
Yes, we did!
She was born just a generation past slavery, a time when there were no cars on the road or planes in the sky, when someone like her couldn't vote for two reasons, because she was a woman and because of the color of her skin. Tonight, I think about all that she's seen throughout her century in America. The heartache and the hope, the struggle and the progress. The times we were told that we can't. The people who pressed on with that American creed, yes, we can. At a time when women's voices were silenced and their hopes dismissed, she lived to see them stand up and speak out and reach for the ballot. Yes, we can. When there was despair in the Dust Bowl and depression across the land, she saw a nation conquer fear itself with a new deal, new jobs, a new sense of common purpose. Yes, we can. When the bombs fell on our harbor and tyranny threatened the world, she was there to witness a generation rise to greatness and a democracy was saved. Yes, we can. She was there for the buses in Montgomery, the hoses in Birmingham, a bridge in Selma, and a preacher from Atlanta who told the people that we shall overcome. Yes, we can. A man touched down on the moon. A wall came down in Berlin. A world was connected by our own science and imagination. And this year, in this election, she touched her finger to a screen and cast her vote. Because after 106 years in America, through the best of times and the darkest of hours, she knows how America can change. Yes, we can. America, we have come so far. We have seen so much, but there's so much more to do. So tonight, let us ask ourselves, if our children should live to see the next century, if my daughters should be so lucky to live as long as Ann Nixon Cooper, what change will they see? What progress will we have made? This is our chance to answer that call. This is our moment. This is our time to put our people back to work and open doors of opportunity for our kids, to restore prosperity and promote the cause of peace, to reclaim the American dream and reaffirm that fundamental truth that out of many we are one, that while we breathe, we hope, and where we are met with cynicism and doubt and those who tell us that we can't, we will respond with that timeless creed that sums up the spirit of a people. Yes, we can.